planet Dolan. From how the alphabet was arranged to how glow sticks glow, we answer some of your most burning questions about life.
Hey there, my name is Melissa. I'll be reading up the questions and answers.
I'm Danger Dolan, and I'm here to blow your mind with truth.
Agent Cracko Patreon asks, is it possible to be allergic to water?
Not just allergic, but it's super deadly even. Very few are numb to its effects. Only animals built for the sea or those adapted to it like Ruby can survive it. You knew your friend? The one that went to the tap to drink some water because he was thirsty? He will be dead in 70 years, alright? Water kills!
Yes. And it is a condition known as aquagenic urticaria, and it occurs when the water comes into contact with the skin rather than when it is drunk. It causes hives, which are red marks that are itchy and accompanied by a burning sensation. Due to the rareness of the disease, there is no known cause of aquagenic urticaria and no known cure. Alejandro Castellano asks, why are presidents on money?
It's more like a leaderboard for rich people. Right, so the more money you have, the more your face will be worth, like Benjamin Franklin. The $100 bill, that dude was loaded. There are some other faces on money, but you'll never recognize them because they simply just don't need to leave their homes ever. When you're that rich, you don't need to do nothing.
In 1929, it was decided that presidents should be on currency since their faces would be familiar to more Americans. The Secretary of Treasury is in charge of the decision, and it was a committee chosen by them that decided to largely feature presidents. In fact, not all the pictures are of presidents, with Benjamin Franklin, Alexander Hamilton, and Samuel Chase the exceptions.
Melissa, why aren't you on the dollar bill, huh? Is it because you're not important, Melissa? Hello?
Hey, you're not on money either.
Oh yeah? You haven't seen who's on the 10 Australian didgeridoo dollar lately, have you? Feeling, wrong or, what?
You know, making your own currency is illegal, right? Akron asks, why doesn't superglue stick to the inside of the tube it's in?
Inside the tube, there's thousands and thousands of little hamsters, similar to the ones that power the Earth, running around and around and around to ensure the mix inside keeps spinning like a cement truck. If more than one hamster ever took a break, it would cause the whole tube to malfunction and dry up.
Aren't hamsters way bigger than a tube of superglue?
No. Now, I'm starting to think you actually haven't been to Australia lately. Let me tell you, things have changed.
Superglue only becomes sticky once it leaves the tube. It's a process called chemical adhesion, whereby the glue is exposed to water vapor in the air and immediately becomes sticky. So, there's nothing special about the tube, other than it stops the air from getting in. That is why superglue can easily dry out if it's not properly sealed. Mistress Adra asks, why don't we know exactly when we fall asleep?
You're up waiting and waiting for the Sandman to finally show and give you the sweet relief of sleep. He can take forever though sometimes, like hours late. That's where insomnia comes from. You're just rolling around your bed forever, sometimes waiting for him. He's always got some kind of damn excuse when he finally shows up.
Oy vey, I don't know why people gotta drive so slow. Traffic was bananas, I'm telling you. It's just one more thing I have to deal with. Oy, first my back, then this. It's always just piling up more and more, I swear.
I don't want to be conscious anymore, okay?
It is difficult to remember the moment one falls asleep because it happens gradually through a number of stages. There is no single moment exactly. The first two stages of sleep are why it's difficult to remember. For instance, during the alpha stage, thoughts become more internal and we are gradually less aware of the outside world. The second stage is known as the theta stage, where brain waves gradually slow down, but there are moments of alpha activity. After this, we enter deep sleep. Mitsumi Jirachi asks, why is Uranus the only planet on its side? The theory is that Uranus was likely struck multiple times by other planets during the early life of our galaxy. Once the sun and planets had formed, they were colliding with one another. It was these impacts that would have knocked Uranus into its 97.8 degree tilt, and a further impact was needed to create the moons, since they all rotate at the same angle.
Dolan, grow up!
Ashley Turtle asks, how is the alphabet sorted?
Oh, well, it just so happens that the inventors of the alphabet were sitting around deciding the order when a hit song by the Beatles came on. You know the one. It's the song that exactly describes and incorporates the letters in a particular order. It was such a sweet tune that it was adopted as the official sorting.
The reason for the order of the alphabet is unknown. However, the Latin alphabet, the English alphabet, has origins in the first alphabet, created by a Semitic-speaking people from Egypt around 1850 to 1700 BC. The order of the alphabet didn't change much over its development. The ancient Greeks used it and added vowels, and then passed it on to the Latins, who added X, Y, and Z to the end. And it was used in ancient Rome. After the fall of the Roman Empire, it eventually became Old English, Middle English, then Modern English. Hey, Dolan, care to sing the ABCs with me to our audience?
Aw, oh, sure thing.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O,
V, W, H, J, A, S, D, G, L, M, X, 43, 6, 8, 9, 7, right? Yeah, no.
Parksile asks, how far is a light year, and why is it called a light year?
Oh, yeah, well, a leap year is something...
No, Dolan. A light year.
Oh, all right. So, light beer is a type of alcohol with less...
Dolan, I don't think you understand. A light year is what they're asking.
Oh, okay, I understand. No, it is the right year. Yeah, it is the right year. I mean, I don't know how you go this long thinking it's like anything else, but...
I think you really need to check up on your hearing. There's clearly something wrong.
Oh yeah, there's something wrong, all right. All I hear is ching ching, baby. Dollar, yeah.
It's called a light year because it is a measure of distance of how far light can travel in a year. Robert Burnham Jr. devised it as an easier way to describe distances in the universe. For instance, the sun is 93 million miles from the Earth, but it is much easier to say it is 8 light minutes away. Lily Pons 15 asks, why do we have a funny bone?
Well, people can have multiple funny bones, actually. Everyone's got at least one. But others can have so many. I myself am made up of 100% funny bones. Muscle, blood, organs, who needs it? I'm all bone, baby. This is why I'm so funny, right, guys? My humorous, creative anecdotes, timeless sarcasm, yeah. Gave you a chuckle, alright? Guys? No?
The funny bone is in fact a nerve that sends messages from your fourth and fifth fingers to the brain. The ulnar nerve, as it's known, runs all the way down from the neck to the hand and is mostly protected by muscle, except when it passes by the elbow, where it presses against the humerus. The nerve is only covered by skin and fat, and hence, is vulnerable to knocks, resulting in a tingling sensation.
Hey Melissa, you want to hear a joke? Your life!
Alpha FB Wildebeest asks, how do glow sticks glow?
Glow sticks glow when someone has a terminal illness nearby. Oh. Ah. Have I done everything I want to in life? My face made it onto money. I've made some pretty sweet jokes. I stayed away from water. But where did it all go wrong? I've noticed that I've been terminally ill ever since I started working with Melissa, so...
Dolan, no! Glow sticks use a chemical reaction, known as chemiluminescence, to create light. This is when two compounds, usually diphenyl oxalate and hydrogen peroxide, react together. This causes electrons to release energy in the form of photons, which are particles of light. These chemicals mix when the glow sticks are bent, because the peroxide is kept in a separate glass tube. The color of the glow stick depends on the dye that is contained within. Now stop being a troll! You know you're not dying!
Hey, I said I was terminally ill, not dying!
What?
Huh?
Lizzie TG asks, why did dinosaurs live before humans?
They were a test run for humans. Clearly they stunk at it though, so the designs were completely scrapped, and that's how humans came to be. Because dinosaurs are utter and total failures. And fat. Really fat.
Dinosaurs tend to be large creatures, and the earliest mammals that evolved at the end of the Triassic period were tiny by comparison. They were nocturnal and lived out of the reach of the dinosaurs. These larger mouse-like animals did not evolve into the larger mammals that populate the Earth now until the dinosaurs went extinct 65 million years ago, when they were able to take advantage of the resources left behind. Mammals could not compete with the dinosaurs for these resources. Therefore, humans could not have existed.
Birds are related to dinosaurs, right?
Well...
Mammal, see, you are so old! All this time and you're not on the dollar? Come on, I mean... Ah! My funny bone! That's not funny.
Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a good one!